बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू ऑल आर फाइन एंड वेल एट योर होम। वेलकम टू कंप्यूटर क्लास एंड वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग यूनिट नंबर 7 फॉर्मेटिंग टेक्स्ट इन वर्ड 2013। प्रीवियसली वी हैव स्टार्टेड दिस लेसन एंड ऑनवर्ड्स इन दिस लेसन टुडे वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग पेज नंबर 82 एंड 83 इन डिटेल। सो लेट्स सी What's interesting ahead we have. Now today, students, we will be discussing about character formatting using font dialog box. So to open the dialog box, you have to first select your document, and then you can see over here they select the home tab. In the font group, you can see this is the font group option. You have to click the dialog box launcher. This opens the options for your font. In this font option, we will be working onwards and make our text colorful. Now we will be discussing character formatting using your font dialog box. The options over here, as we opened it, this is the select font color first option. With its name, it is clear you can make your text colorful from this option. Next to it is the font styles. You can select different kind of fonts from here, and then select font styles like regular, bold options are there. And after that is the numbers. You can see as this is the size of your font size, you can select it from here. Afterwards, we have this underline option. There is a line, that what kind of line you can select from here you desire for your text. Next to it is the underline color option, which color line you want. And afterwards, there are special effects. You can see you can make your character small and bigger, this strike through, these options. And this is the view preview of the text, how it look like when you select from here. Hope you all understood this one. Now with the name of the text effects, it's in Word 2013 there is a new button called text effects in the font group. As you can see, this is the font group area. Next to it there is a A with the colored one. When you click it, this button, you can see this window opens, and from here you can make your text more colorful. We will be discussing further more options about it. As we have discussed, we are discussing about font effects. Now we will be discussing different kinds of font effects. First we have changing the color. You can see this option. When you select, you can change the color of your text. And next to it is outline. It gives outline to your text with different colors. And after it is, you can see shadow option. It gives your text shadow. And next to it is glow. It makes your text glowing. As you can see the example over here I have given you. And next to it is reflection. You can see this is the reflection option. It gives reflection of your text. So these are the different options you can select and make your text colorful. Now we move on towards our today's written work, and that is from your book page number 90 and 91. We have objective type questions, and we will be doing question number 1, fill in the blanks, and the correct options are given above, and we will be filling our blanks with the help of this question bank. So our first question, objective type questions, book page number 90 and 91, fill in the blanks, is the part A is dash alignment option is used to align the text to the both left and right margins. Now you have to think for it, that which option makes our text aligned on the both sides. And part B, the font group on the home tab offers a quick way to apply some of the most common used dash formatting options. Now you have to think for it that what will come in this blank. Now part C, the keyboard shortcut for dash alignment is Control plus E. You have to think for it which aligns Control plus E in which manner, to the left, right, center. You have to think for the answer. Now part D, clicking the home tab displays the dash group. Which group it shows us, you have to think for the answer and mark it. Now part E, the last option, is the borders and shading option is available in the dash drop down menu. In which menu is it available, you have to think for it. Now I hope my children have finished their fill in the blanks and it's time to review your answers. Let's check the answers for the fill in the blanks. The first part A part answer is the justify, and B part answer is corrector, and C part C answer is center, and part D correct answer is font, and last part E answer is border. Hope my children have finished their work on their books. This is a book work and you must finish it. Okay, with this answer key matching, we have moved towards the end of our today's explanation of this lesson, and I hope my children have understood the different font dialog box options and text effect as well, and I wish that you will be practicing these things at your home in your Word 2013 to make your text colorful. And don't forget to finish your quiz available in the Google Classroom and finish your fill in the blanks question in your book part. Have a good day. Take care. See you inshallah in the next class. Allah Hafiz.